It's me, your girl T-Tut, here with another weekly skin tip. So today we're going to talk about ingrown hairs. Okay, so this happens. You get ingrown hairs when the shaved hair or the tweezed hair grows back into the skin. It causes an inflamed and painful bump. This condition is most common in men and women who do hair removal on a regular basis, whether it be your face, your brows, whatever. It could happen anywhere you tweeze or shave your hair, underarms, all of that. So if you are pulling and stretching your face, that is what could be causing the ingrown hairs, because when you stretch it, you're opening up the skin and the pores, and the cut hair could possibly go back down into the skin. Same thing with the tweezed hair. The fragmented hair that's left in there could grow awkward, and then it'll cause the ingrown hair and the painful bumps and all of that. So there are a few things that you could do to prevent this. One, you wash your face before shaving, or the area that you're going to shave, before, with warm water and a mild cleanser. And I have a mild facial cleanser for both my kings and my queens. For the queens, it's Aswan Facial Wash. And for my kings, it's Blue Lotus Facial Cleanse. It's mild, and you can use it on your skin. On your face. It won't hurt you when you go to shave or tweeze. But you want to do that with a mild cleanser before you shave. You also want to add a lubricant or a gel before you shave. But here's the hack. Put it on and let it sit a few minutes before you shave. Most people, they put the shaving cream on or the lubricating gel on and then immediately start shaving. Let it sink in. Let it get into your skin and soften up everything. It'll help if you let it sit for a while before you actually start to shave. The next thing is to make sure that your razor is sharp every time you use it. A lot of us, even with just the shaving of your underarms, you know, we just, okay, I'm gonna use it again, especially if it's a reusable razor. But you gotta make sure it's sharp, especially if you've been having issues with ingrown hair. It could be that your blade is not sharp. So make sure that you're using a sharp blade every time. Make sure that you are rinsing your blade or razor every time you stroke your face. So you stroke once and you rinse. Stroke and you rinse. When you don't rinse, that those hairs that's on the blade, when you stroke again, run the risk of getting stuck back in your face, going down, and there you go, the ingrown hair. Rinse every time so you don't have that problem. Now, once you finish shaving, rinse your face with warm water, pat dry, and use a moisturizer. Okay, I have a moisturizer. Yes, it's in my women's line, but it's for anybody with skin that needs moisture. Use it. You don't have to use mine, but use moisturizer. These little things that I just told you, they're simple that you should be doing anyway. Shaving, this will help prevent the ingrown hair. So if you're having an issue, make sure you watch this again. Go back, do the things that I'm telling you to do, which you should be doing anyway, but let the shaving cream sit a little while longer before you start to shave. Clean your face before you start to shave. Moisturize after you shave. And don't pull your face when you shave. Just shave. Just shave. Okay? Do these things. If you need a moisturizer or facial wash, please go to my website, queentutcosmetics.com. Check out my items. Purchase them if you'd like. Try it out. See if it works for you. But definitely, clean your face, lubricate, moisturize, okay? This has been another weekly skin tip with your girl, T-Tut, and I want you to have a great day.